It's nice like this, feeling right like this. I never really spend no time like this, huh? Your second time at the crib, knowing I might not hit. You said what I look like my chick, yeah.
What's up, guys? Squatch and Helena, and I'm back with another video. Yes, I am sitting on the floor in my room because it's probably the easiest space I can use right now. But today's video is going to be a video on how I clean my ears. Because the first video I'm going to be posting before this video is the video of when I got my second ear hole piercing. You guys see it right here, the little stud. So that's going to be the first video that I'm going to be posting before this video. I got it done on Wednesday, and today is Sunday, so a couple of days. So yeah, this video is going to be on how I clean my ears. And also, in case people were wondering, I'm going to also show you guys how I cleaned my nose piercing when I first got it done. And then I have a little burn that's healing now on my finger, and I'm going to show you guys how I still clean it to this day until it's fully, you know, healed. I'll show you guys how I clean that too. So in the next clip, I'm going to show you guys what you guys will need to clean these three things. So for my ears, I'll show you guys that first. So I'll just show you guys one thing at a time as I clean them. So for my ears, I just use rubbing alcohol and some Q-tips. Okay, so I'm gonna try to get this up close as I can. So let's go. Okay, so first, I'm just gonna take the alcohol and put it like this. I am spraying it over the trash can just in case it decides to come off the thing. So I use both sides of the Q-tip because I clean the front and back. So when I get it up close, I'm just gonna do circular motions around. Circular motions around it. Times. Then I'll take the other side of the Q-tip. Oh, there it goes. Spill that a little bit on the Q-tip. And I'll lift up my ear and clean the back in circular motions as well. Circular motions here. And that's that. So now that I showed you guys that one, I'm gonna do the second ear in fast motion. You guys know what I'm gonna say. They're both clean. I did just wash my hands before I did this, but I'm gonna take my hand sanitizer and put some on my hands because now we have to twist it. Just make sure that when you do this, your hands are clean. I did just wash my hands, but I'm going to sanitize them still, just in case. So now I'm gonna take my ear and I'm just gonna twist it a couple times just to make sure you guys can't see, but it is moving. Yeah. it's moving pretty good. Just a couple times. Just so that it doesn't get stiff, you know? Alright. Pretty good. Okay, so for my nose piercing, I was told to use dial soap. I have my few tips, but dial soap. And then for the pain, I was told to spray Bactine on it. So that's what I'm gonna show you guys right now. And I'll show you guys how to, you know, twist it and move it around and stuff. But I was told to use dial soap and Bactine for the pain. I also spray the Bactine on my ears too, for the pain that I feel sometimes, but I only spray it when I feel the pain. That's what I do with my nose too. So let's go ahead with cleaning it. So first, I'm gonna take a Q-tip. I usually wet it, but because I'm not at the sink, I'm gonna use this water bottle. So this is how I do it. I wet the Q-tip a little bit. And then take the dial soap, just rub it. But this is what I did when I was cleaning it and when I first got it done. I do clean it here and there, but I don't clean it as often because it's pretty healed. I mean, you probably still should clean it, but I don't as often as I probably should. But this is the process I did. I still do it sometimes, like I said, but not as often anymore. But yeah, just take about that much on there. Just rub it until you see it. And you just do pretty much like the ear. And you rub it on there. Rub it on there. Not as much soap on there as I thought it was, but rub it on there in circular motions. Just a little bit. And then I usually take, to get the soap off, I take the other end of the Q-tip and put it in more water. And just wipe it. Wipe it until you see no more soap on there. Wipe it a little bit. There we go. And that's how you clean the nose. And like I said, if it's hurting, you just use this. And then after you guys clean your nose, you want to also do the same thing and twist like the ear. Twist, but also make sure your hands are clean. Twist. I still twist it just so that, you know. And then after you twisted it a couple times, you wanna move it up and stuff so that nothing gets stiff. That's how you wanna do it. So on to the next and last thing I'm gonna do is my burn. So yeah, I'll explain to you. First of all, before I show you guys how I cleaned it, when I first got the burn, it was hurting so bad that I couldn't take it out of the ice water. So I left it in the ice water, and it was pretty hard to do anything because I had to leave it in the ice water. But that's fine. So I just left it in the ice water. And this may sound crazy, but I slept with my finger in the ice water too. But then by the time I woke up in the morning, it was fine. So, ever since that day, ever since the ice water day, after it was done burning and stuff, I've been cleaning it with peroxide. So, I'm going to move the phone and I'm going to show you guys how I clean it. Right, so, I take the cup because it's easier and I didn't want to use dishes for a small little tiny burn. It's healing now. The skin is, as you guys can see, the skin is closing up. I'll insert a picture of what it did look like when it first was burnt. So I'll show you guys what it looks like. And this is what it looks like now. So the skin is closing up, but just pour a little bit of peroxide in the cup. For me, when I was first doing this, it was burning a little bit, but it's fine now. It doesn't burn that much. I don't think it burns at all, but I just tilt it and soak it in there for a couple seconds. It doesn't have to be super long, but I soak it in there for a couple seconds. Sorry, my hands are in the way. Should be good, and it's, you know, turning a little fuzzy and like white from the peroxide. It's bubbly, so that's what it's doing. But I do that and then I'll let it dry. Pretty dry. I just take some Neosporin and rub it on there. But since mine is healed, I don't put a band-aid on it. But if you guys have a burn and it's not super healed yet, I would put a Neosporin on it and then wrap it up with a band-aid. But because mine is okay, I just, you know, leave it to dry out now because it's healing. So I'll leave mine to dry out, but it's doing good. But before, I would do the same process, but wrap it up with a band-aid, or even gauze works too, but I'd wrap it up and then leave it. But now because it's healing, I'll just, you know, apply the Neosporin and, you know, let it air out because it's healing up now. But alright guys, that's gonna conclude my video. I hope that this video helps you guys with anything that you guys might need to be cleaning or need to clean. I hope this video helps you. Please like, comment, subscribe, and I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye, I love God.